Assalamu alaikum everyone. I believe you all are safe. So we have completed chapter number 3 by yesterday, and today we will discuss exercise. In chapter number 3 you have read a lot of ideas. I mean, you have read about the present life of Mr. Chips, how he is living, and then how he met with people, how he greeted them, and then the chapter ends at a very interesting point that Mr. Chips was once married and no one knows about it. So hopefully in coming week we will read the chapter in which we will also read how Mr. Chips was married and where his wife is now. I mean, why she isn't with him right now, or if she was died, what happened to her? So there are a lot of questions. I mean, you must have those questions. So, but first we have to end this chapter with proper exercise, right? So here are, I found a very interesting page on internet, so I'm sharing it with you through this video. Synonyms: pretentious is showy, artificial, which means dikhave wala, convenient, suitable, which means asani, stroll, walk, which means chahalkadmi, crumped, a soft cake, khasta. Khasta is like when you have a very crunchy or crumped biscuit, or when you try to eat it, the morsels fell down. तो वो जो एक होता है ना, उसको हम कहते हैं क्रम्प्ड, खस्ता. बहुत मजेदार सा होता है वो. Shallow, shallow is not deep, कम गहरा, और sometimes we use it खोखला. Soaked, डूबा हुआ, बिल्कुल dip हुआ हुआ, dipped. Okay, caddy is small container, और कोई छोटा सा बर्तन जिसमें चीज बंद करके रखी जाए. Glance, look, निगाह. Remains, remaining things, I mean what leftovers you can say, बाकियात. Trash, beat, मारना. Cheeky is disrespectful, impudent, बदतमीजा, ठीक है, गुस्ताख. Placid is peaceful, pursukoon. Etiquette is enough, sufficient, kafi, munasib. Mental peace is a fireplace, yani angithi. Fixture card is a card with time and place of hunt, yani koi ek aisi jagah card hote jisme ye sare details likhi ho. Bell's letter, bell, यानी के writing of purely literary character, यानी अदबी ज़ौक वाला बंदा. Assiduous is diligent, hard worker, मेहनती. Profound, great, or too much, बहुत ज़्यादा. Freemasonry is secret brotherhood, यानी किसी से आप secretly when you are friend with someone. Bald, yani ganja, hairless. Occasional, irregular, kabhi kabhar. Spidery, curving like spider, theek hai, tedha medha hona. Legible, readable, yani you can read someone's writing. Script is also a writing, but the script is specifically for some purpose, like script for movies, script for dramas. Fuss, excitement. But it first is not a, the excitement is not a positive word, but a negative word. Sometimes we used to say don't create fuss here, ki yahan koi jo pareshani na dikhao ya koi tamasha na lagao. So it is not a positive word, but it is a negative word. So this is all about this antonym, sorry, synonym, alfaz maini aapko maine bata diye. Now I'm moving to short question of this chapter. So the first short question is, how did Mr. Chips live at Mrs. Wickett's house? After his retirement, Mr. Chips decided to live at Mrs. Wickett's house just across the road. The house was not decorated, but the room was comfortable. Whenever weather was pleasant, he go to play fields and watch games. He used to serve new boys with tea and cake, and he used to read books, novels, and Time newspaper. who was Major Collingwood and where was he killed? Major Collingwood was an old student of Brookfield. He was uncle of student named Branksome. Once Chips thrashed him for climbing on the roof of gymnasium to get a ball out of gutter. Collingwood had been little rude to Mrs. Wickets at time, but he was good at heart. He was killed in Egypt while fighting in army. What did Chips comment about Greek and Latin? He was not, despite his long year of assiduous teaching, a very profound classical scholar indeed. He thought of Latin and Greek for more as a dead language because no one speaks them, because from which English gentlemen ought to know a few quotations than a living tongues that had ever been spoken by living people. He liked those short leading articles in the Times that introduce a few tags that he recognized to be among swindling number of people who understood such things was to him a kind of secret and valued free masonry. It represented, he felt, one of the chief benefit to be derived from classical education. So that's all about this exercise and these questions, answers, and words, meaning, or synonyms. So you can prepare them. If you have any questions, you can ask in comments where the video is uploaded on a YouTube channel. Or if you have any query, you can directly ask your HOD, or if you are in contact with your teacher, you can ask them. We will explain it. So prepare it. Have a nice day ahead. Good luck. Khuda hafiz.